Okay, we are back. We have find our issue. The problem was I had misspelled the variable name. I dropped out the N, and KSP couldn't find the cPilot transform, which meant that we had a error message, although, but it wasn't read. So I missed it. Here it is. Internal C could not find C transform of name because I had misnamed the variable. So that's something to watch out for. The value assigned has to be the correct spelling and capitalization, and the variable name you assigned value to also has to be correct. Spelling and capitalization. So this should work. And anyway, while with that error occurring, what's happening is that the internal is loaded correctly, should be loaded correctly, but what happened is the curvil is spawned at the root reference node of the internal, which is about here, and it is using the Y direction, which is pointing forward, and Z direction, which is pointing down, which is what you see here. Y is up, the top of his head is pointing forward, and he is facing the ground. So now we go back. I have corrected the issue there, and just make sure our external is pointing to the correct internal file. We reload our database. As a side note here, it's better to use the reload function in Module Manager instead of the Alt F12 database reload because Alt F12 reload will ignore all the Module Manager settings and reload everything as if Module Manager doesn't exist. So if you have mods and modded parts, some of them might not load because they're not the KSP's part loader is not reading the Module Manager settings. So we switch to our part again, command module. The missing internal C transform error should be gone. No, it's not. Enter window left. Okay, so we're missing the okay, so let's see. Internal camera switch, camera transform. Ah, yes. Another thing I missed, because originally I thought it was because you couldn't use the same transform for the camera and the collider. Anyway, at least, yes, the orientation is correct. There we go. Now, why is this helmet still on? Allow, three L's. Again, another misspelling there. That wasn't as serious. So two L's, again, spelling, capitalization, very important. Very easy to make mistakes on those, and things break or go unexpected like we just have. So we reload the database, the camera transforms should be working. And we should have a working base internal that you can use to populate with instrumentations and other internal props. Okay, so if he has no helmet, excellent. Looks like everything's working. Got our view inside. And there we go, our left wind or right window view. Now with the window, you have full 180 degrees of view, so you can look back and see yourself. Now we'll go back, left window, excellent. Left window is working correctly as well. So there we go. We have a setup, a working external and working with properly aligned internal space. There's our crew hatch, caught the ladder, come down, drop, excellent, grab, climb up, and board. And there's our view. And as a little, I suppose we could do this. Since I have Raster Prop Monitor installed, I'm going to try this out. Should work. Name, JSI, transparent, pod. And let's see, what are my settings here? Spaces. Not that one. Parts command. Let's see, transparent. There we go. That's the setting I need. And we just need to give it the correct transform to switch shaders on, which is that. Close our module. Now we should get a transparent external to see the Kerbal and the cockpit. This is a good way to adjust your Kerbal transform in the IVA if you're a stickler for correct positioning and orientation and height and all that stuff. But again, if you're not using transparent pods, whether it's SFR's plugin, which I don't know anything about, or transparent pod rest or prop monitor's transparent pod. There we go. We can see him inside. You can use this to adjust his seat transform position. So there we have it. We have working pod, working crew hatch, ladder, and IVA with camera switch. So just a quick recap, we have our mesh. These are all made 1-to-1 scale. So these are all, this is 1.25 meter diameter in the middle here, and this is slightly larger. And the internal is made to the same scale. And then they're exported as FBX. Import into Unity, scale factor set to 1, rig set to none because they don't have any animations, same for the interior, and then in Unity we added window switch transforms. So these are triggers that when you're in internal, double click on these window panes will let you jump to that position with the camera spawned. And for the external side, we have our airlock and ladder assigned their proper tags and layers, part triggers, ladder and airlock tags. Have our main colliders for the top and the main fuselage, which are these, and their correct relative orientations. which is this. There's the orientation for the IVA. Again, position and rotation should be zeroed out for your root object that has the part tools export script. Same goes for the external part. Position, rotation all zeroed out, and you rotate the inside to match the stock objects, stock command modules orientation, which is this. So coming back in here, if we go back to vehicle assembly building, I'm dwelling on this part because this part is the trickiest part in doing setting up IVAs. So let's see, can I get this close to the left here? Let's get a side by side. So there we go. So here we have the default orientation in vehicle assembly building and the export orientation from Unity. And then you can see the IVA and external are properly aligned, and there's their relative orientation at export. Okay? So let's see. So we got our exports. We set up our configs. Get rid of this. Set up our configs, your name, rescale factor. I stick to rescale factor of 1 to make things easy for myself. And the important part here is the internal node for your this config file is applied to this part here, and it points to the correct internal model that you want loaded with this external command module. And then for the internal config, we have our minimum basics here. Well, actually, we don't need the windows. The minimum basics are, well, technically not even the internal seat, because if you don't have one, it's just going to use the main root transform for your orientation, which you saw the results earlier. Jebediah was facing down, or facing the ground and pointing up, which would work for which is essentially the orientation for this part. So if you have a vertical launched pod, then you know that orientation would work. So this is Y is up, Z is forward in VAB, in a vehicle assembly building, and X is to the right over here while you're looking forward. And then in ship space plane hangar, the orientation is this. Right, Y is forward, Z is down, again X is to the right. So that's your VAB orientation, which is what you export out from Unity, and that's your space plane hangar orientation. So there you have it. That should be everything, and thanks for watching. If you got any questions, again, first refer to here. And any specific questions, you can post in here, and a lot of good folks will do their best to help you out.